this is the, if not the largest, rare earth, resource in the heart of the United States. And one of the biggest problems that the United States has got is where to onshore these critical materials. And Halleck Creek is this strategic resource. It is a cornerstone for the US.
All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Chris Gibbs. He is the CEO of American Rare Earths. And Chris, great to see you again. How are you?
Doing great, thanks, Steve.
Yeah, I know that you and I talked recently about the importance of updating your mineral resource estimate, and that's what you're announcing today. So first off, congratulations on getting this done. I know it takes a lot of work in getting everything together. So overall, you're very happy with where things are at?
Couldn't be more pleased, Steve. This is outstanding, outstanding news to see us obviously increasing this resource. We came out of, as you know, doing a drill campaign towards the end of last year, and that was an infill drill program. And what we've come out with is essentially just over a 12% increase in our JORC resource to now take this JORC resource to 2.63 billion tons, and could not be more pleased.
This would, I imagine, put this particular project in a very different category, especially with where it's located, the type of land that it sits on. Now you've got this update as well. There's a lot of positive things moving forward for Halleck Creek.
A lot of positive things, Steve. This is the, if not the largest, rare earth, resource in the heart of the United States. And one of the biggest problems that the United States has got is where to onshore these critical materials. And Halleck Creek is this strategic resource. It is a cornerstone for the US. This is a massive deposit. We've only essentially got this JORC resource on 16% of the surface area. The resource is open at depth and at width, and this thing is huge. And so it's in the heart of the United States. As I said, the US has the largest challenge is where to source these rare earths. So what we've got is the solution to this problem. And it's outstanding. Could not be more pleased. And we've been moving this project forward, and we've got a lot of great news to come too, Steve.
Yeah.
And we'll talk more on that, I'm sure.
Yeah, I know in the news release you talked a lot about the ability to process the rare earths, and that's something the work that's ongoing right now. And I guess in essence you've de-risked it a lot. This just continues that process, I would imagine.
That's correct, Steve. We came out earlier with a scoping study, and which actually had a lot of this metallurgy within that. And we are actually updating our scoping study as a result of this increase in the resource. And this will have a significant impact because we've seen if you take the Cowboy State Mine area, which is what we're developing first, we've seen a massive, just over 20, well, it's 29.4% increase in the resource in that area and an increase in grade. This will all flow through to the economics. Now, the important thing is on the metallurgy front. And as we had announced earlier, we've had breakthroughs here with regards to the metallurgy. This ore responds very well to magnetic separation and gravity separation. So this is all just physical separation processes
Yeah.
prior to using any chemicals or any significant processing technology. And we're getting significant upgrades up to 10 times in terms of the grade. So that's before we get to the chemical processing. So this is significant. And obviously with the increased resource, this will all flow through to something very positive in terms of the economics. And that's the news that will be coming out into the near future.
Yeah, new scoping study you say in there about February 2025, so it's obviously coming up in the next little while. I want to ask you quickly just about President Trump is now officially in office. I don't think he had taken office but last time you and I chatted, but he's very clear about the type of critical minerals that they're looking for in the United States, and obviously this fits right in, as you mentioned a bit earlier. So is that something that you constantly talk about in trying to get you've got so obviously the people in the state that are happy with you, but also getting that Washington buy-in as well.
Well, we're fortunate in that this project is actually located. Yeah, we've got both state and federal lands, and we're moving the project forward on the state lands at first, which, yeah, there's a pathway to permitting on the state lands. But at the
Yeah.
same time, the majority of this project, yeah, a significant part of this project is on federal lands. And so, but you know, the wider challenge here, yes, is to the long term for the United States. And as President Trump has said, onshoring these materials is key, and you know, we're part of the solution, and it's right in the heart of the United States. One of my colleagues was recently asked the question, do we need to buy Greenland to solve our rare earth problem? And the answer was, of course not. All we need to do is fund the development of the Halleck Creek project in right here in the heart of the United States in Wyoming. And that's exactly what we've got here. And so we're very well positioned. And the Trump administration is very supportive of the resource industry and onshoring these critical minerals into the United States. So we're very well positioned and very excited with what this means for our shareholders.
Chris, thank you so much. Good update. Really appreciate it. Strong work and good to see you again. We'll talk soon, okay?
Thank you, Steve.
All
Appreciate it.
right, Chris Gibbs, the CEO of American Rare Earths.